comic book history, there's Helen Slater's interpretation. What do you arrive and find, and what do you want to make out of it?
Yeah. Well, obviously that's a daunting feeling to arrive at a point where this is a character that is so developed and so many people already love. So there I have responsibility, and I arrive, you know, wanting to just to stay true to a lot of that. But what I want to bring is I love her humanity, even though she is an alien. I love that she really has a lot of discovering to do and growth and makes mistakes. You know, I think she's so relatable, and I just want to stay true to that.
Did you audition with Kara scenes or Supergirl scenes?
No. I can't. Oh, I'm trying to remember. Mostly Kara. I think the audition scenes were Kara and Jimmy. Kara and Wynn, for sure. And Kara and Kat. So I don't think there are any Supergirl.
So do you book this role and then immediately just like run to the gym and like yeah. So yes. What was that? What did you do? Or did you have to like step up your workouts? Did you just
I did. Yeah. I immediately, like, I am such a pacifist in my everyday life, and I don't think I've ever hit anyone before. And so I definitely had to learn technique, like how to actually punch someone and not hurt yourself more than you're hurting the person you're punching. And so boxing was part of it, and core work and Pilates and plyometrics, a lot of it.
Did that change your mindset too, like getting yourself physically transformed?
Yeah. The motivation there and the drive, it definitely affects. It because I don't have a choice, you know, like I can't sit down and be like, oh, I'm done, I want some popcorn. You know, like I have to stay on top of the game.
The wire
work is really difficult, but so fun. And when you get it right, like watching the result is exhilarating. That's a really, really cool feeling to know what it felt like, the energy I had to exert to create those flying scenes, and then the way they look is really rewarding.
Have you met Gal Gadot, and do you feel playing Supergirl and her coming as Wonder Woman in the same year, both two of DC's biggest female heroes, do you feel the two of you at some point have a conversation that has to be had between you?
Sure. We've not met yet, but I'm sure we'll probably relate a lot.
How did it feel to see yourself in the costume?
There's this internal feeling, something changes, you know, it's this transformation almost that, to the point where I don't really recognize myself when I'm in it. You know, I feel like a different person.
On a practical level, what do you love about the costume and what do you not love so much?
That's a really good question. I love that I grew up as a dancer, so it feels like leotard and skirt tights that I wore when I was in a ballerina. But what is impractical and sometimes painful, even though I think I'm very lucky in terms of my suit, I know a lot of people have masks that sweat and don't breathe at all. Mine has a corset. My cape is a corset. And so that sometimes when I'm on the wire is like, it's constricting.
So where are you doing your own stunts?
I'm trying to do a lot of them, because I want to. I think they're so fun. There are some that I just can't stay. I really can't. But I'm trying to. My stunt double is amazing. She was Jen Garner's alias and Buffy's, and she's all over the place. And she's so cool. I wish people could see what they go through. Like, it's insane.
Are you trying to bring a little bit of that dancer's grace to the flying and to the movements of her?
Oh, of course. Well, I think what's cool is to try to bring kind of a femininity to her strength. And, you know, you see Superman, and it's obviously this solid thing, but I do like the idea of bringing in, like, a grace to it and a fluidity and kind of this
when you get this pilot, you have pretty good.